Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to a new episode of The Gully Squad. In reality, many entertainers, you know, they do transcend. They transcend past their level of just entertaining us. You know, they transcend into people we wind up admiring as family relatives, as people that we could see as part of our own family. And I was just thinking, you know, John Witherspoon did that to many people. You know, I got to give respect to Mr. Bang 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 himself, you know, God rest his soul. He just recently died. And I was just thinking, I need to, you know, say my words and say what I feel about the situation. You know, a lot of people, you know, celebrities die that we don't personally know. I didn't know the man. You know, I didn't know him from Jack Adams in the sense of him personally. But he was one of those comedians, very funny man, been in the game for a long period of time. Long period of time, actually. But we got to know him as, you know, Pops. John Witherspoon, he played, you know, he played the same role frequently for the past 20, 30 years that I've seen him. And it was more of a situation where he was the funny Pops. He was the Pops that we looked up to, you know, in a comedic role. You know, that crazy funny uncle we all have. Or some of us have. I mean, I had a uncle my goddamn self who was goddamn hysterical. But he wasn't a comedian. He was just does a weird hysterical type of man. Just, you know, 5 foot nothing. You know, he was Jewish, and his son was Jehovah's Witness. It was a strange situation. Let's put it this way: I went to mosques. I went to the temples. I had religion coming up my ass when I was a young man. But that's a different story, different podcast. But anyway, so. We all had that uncle that was, you know, that was funny, that or could be funny, and Pops, you know, he transcended that aspect of entertaining. He did, you know, because when you listen to him, he's like, you was able to relate to him in a weird fatherly way, you know. For some of us, they didn't have dad in the house, because my dad, I don't know what the fuck he was at. I don't know. I didn't have my dad in the house, you know. And a lot of American young men. Are like that. We don't have our pops in the house, you know, regarding, you know, social situations and the dynamics of the family, you know. I personally didn't have pops in the house. I didn't have that. I had male figures in my family. Don't get me wrong. I just didn't have pops in the house. So when you looked at, you know, John Witherspoon as an entertainer and his comedic roles that he portrayed, you know, subsequently, we wind up looking at him as a father figure. You know, looking back at it. And I think that is the reason why we adored his ass. God damn it, I'm going to say that shit. I think that's the reason why Mr. Bang 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 himself, bang, bang, bang. You know, he got so much admiration. Because we looked at him as exactly that, as Pops. So, you know, he's... You know, some entertainers, they do transcend that role of being an entertainer and just a comedic role, you know. In the Boondocks, and a lot of people know this, he played, you know, Pops and Grandpops in the Boondocks. He was the old, funny old character, you know, telling the boys to cut that shit out, you know. But that was it. That was his role. That's how we saw him. You know, he was in Fridays and, you know, telling Ice Cube, you don't need a gun. You need to fight with your hands and be a man. That's how real men roll. You know, that's how we resolve our situations. We fight with our hands. That's, you know, scenes like that, you know, conversations like that he had. And then he had to roll with the Wayne brothers. You know, he was like the male father figure of the Wayne brothers on that TV series that went out for years. People forget that shit. I didn't forget it. This shit was funny as hell. So he always played that type of role, that Pops role. And as we grew up, you know, I grew up, you know, We related to him. Subconsciously, goddammit. You know? So, and there's been others, you know, other male father figure role entertainers, you know. Now, I don't want to say my age because, goddamn, you know, I got some age on me. You wouldn't believe that shit. I just look you fucking young, yeah. I got different DNA. We'll talk about that another level. But anyway, another person that was a real major father figure, this was years ago, though. You know, I was legit. I was like, real baby. I'm 4 or 5 years old. I was watching Good Times, the Good Time reruns. And James Evans, you know, he was the man of the goddamn house. Now, James Evans is a little bit different. See, James Evans wasn't a comedian. Now, even though we're just talking about John Witherspoon, I was giving respect to John Witherspoon. I'm talking basically about the male figures in comedic roles on television, you know, and what we see growing up, you know, as men growing up in an urban environment, like myself. I was growing in Brooklyn. Concrete goddamn jungle. And I'm not talking about Brooklyn now. I don't know how Brooklyn now. I'm talking about when Brooklyn was rough. When shit got popped off years ago. I mean, Brooklyn was rough. You know what I'm saying? People was getting mugged left and right, but it was the streets. But anyway, like I said, I'm not talking about Brooklyn now. Gentrified Brooklyn. I ain't talking about that shit. I'm talking about ways back when you walking on the wrong road, buddy. You about to get this work. You about to get this heat. That Brooklyn. But anyway, growing up in Brooklyn back then, you know, years ago, you know, watching Good Times and looking at, you know, James Evans as the father figure, he was like the father figure that a lot of urban males who didn't have a male in a household like that, he was a father figure that we looked up to. And watching him in many ways, you know, James was a strong father figure on Good Times. Like he was a different type of father figure you looked at on the show. He had a very stern attitude about everything. Plus, at the same time, those who remember Good Times, you know, they had a real life. You know, they stayed in the projects. They, you know, it was, you know, money was tight. You know, moms is, she's working. James is, you know, he would have a job, and you know, sometimes he would lose the job, and then he got to get another job. But he was a hard working man. But he was stern. He was a man. He wasn't no beta man. He wasn't no weak man. He commanded respect from everyone. Everyone respected him. And he was like a larger than life type of father figure. You know, even though it was a comedic show. See, people gotta remind yourself, Good Times was actually a comedic show with a lot of social justice themes into it. You know, Good Times was a deep movie. A deep TV show. But James himself, he was different from the other characters. They were a little bit more lighthearted, you know. Then a mother, and then a sister, and then, of course, Jimmy Walker, Mr. Dynamite, Dynamite! You know, he, comedic role and shit. He was a little goofball on him. He acted a little coonish, you know. Michael was the woke one. If you think about it, little Michael, he was woke before woke was woke. Back then, he was telling people back then, Jesus was black, but people wasn't feeling it. People didn't understand what he was coming from. But he was telling you back then, oh, Jesus is black. You better know what time it is. They lying to your ass. But anyway, but James had that fatherly, strong male outlook to him. And for those who didn't have a father figure inside the home, a pops inside the home, James was kind of like that. Now, I could only speak for myself, but I know a lot of young black males, a lot of males in general who didn't have their dad, I think could relate to what I'm saying. You know, especially if you spent years growing up watching something, you know, you see a different aspect, or you see a more positive role in the sense of male leadership in those type of, you know, shows. And not all of them, of course. Goddamn, not all of them. But Good Times, you know, James Evans, he was one of those entertainers. He was one of those actors that kind of transcended entertaining, if you think about it, throughout the years. Because to this day, I'm a grown-ass goddamn man. But I still think of James Evans as, you know, a very stern, fatherly, strong black man that held the family down. You know, if you had to think, if you didn't have a father in the house and you had to look at something, and you saw one that was positive, especially at that time, you would definitely think it was James. James held the whole damn family down. You know, he made sure all the kids weren't on drugs. He made sure that the daughter, you know, she was gorgeous. Oh, goddamn, she was gorgeous. He made sure that she was out there stripping and hoeing and doing, you know, recklessness, you know, making sure Michael was staying out of trouble, you know, all doing this in a very harsh environment, in a harsh urban environment. James wasn't having it. I mean, one time they try to get his oldest son, in good times, they try to get his oldest son, one of the gang members, try to get the oldest son in good times into the gangs. And he didn't want to get in the gang. He actually didn't want to get in the gang, but they're like, no, you're getting in the gang, no matter if you like it, if you're not, if you want. And James is walking down the street with his wife. Unbeknownst to him, he's seeing his son being manhandled by these two thugs. And James said, if you don't put your hands over my boy, I'm knocking all your shit out. And the thing about him was, even though he was in a comedic role, even when he said it, you knew he was in. Well, first of all, he was bulky. He was mad bulky too. That was another thing. James was like, he was one of those rock solid black men. You know, he was one of those guys that you could tell don't even need to work out. He was a straight diesel. But he said to those kids, if you don't unhand my boy, I'm breaking all y'all teeth. And when he said that shit, you could tell he meant it. Even though he was acting, you could tell he meant it. He's like, I'm knocking out all your teeth. And they looked at him like, God damn, is he playing or is he acting? But that's the impression. And like I said, this is years later. Think about that. This is years later. And I still remember that scene. It's still in my psyche. That particular scene. Not because of the violence that he said he was going to do, but the respect he kind of garnished, even in the roles of acting, of how to play. Had to be a male, in a male role figure, as a father figure. So some actors do transcend entertaining, though they may not be the real person that they portray in the TV show, in the movies. But sometimes they are. Sometimes their personality, no matter what character they're playing, comedic or whatever, their pops shows out, their father shows out, their manliness shows out, their love, their endearment shows out. And you can't, I don't care what type of actor you are, you can't fake that. You can't fake that genuineness that shines from watching that particular actor. Now, John Witherspoon, he had that. John Witherspoon had that. James Amos, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, James Amos, he had that. So I got to give respect to those entertainers. I got to give respect to, you know, John Witherspoon for giving us that. Because though he was a comic and though he was an entertainer, he transcended that aspect of entertaining. We saw Pops in him because he was Pops in many ways. Even though he probably wasn't trying to, it genuinely came out. On that note, I bid you peace.
On that note, family, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Support the Gully Squad at patreon.com. And remember, we are one.